இது நம்ம ஏயா கோச்சிங் சென்டர் அங்க படிக்கலாம்
இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா லைக் பண்ணுங்க ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுங்க थैंक यू
प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन असिस्टेंट रिप्रोडक्टिव असिस्टेंट रिप्रोडक्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी जस्ट इंट्रोडक्शन ओनली हैड गिवन दिस क्लास वी विल सी द मेथड्स फर्स्ट वी विल सी इंट्रायूट्रिन इनसेमिनेशन दिस प्रोसीजर is to treat infertile men. That's men who is having low sperm count can undergo this procedure. That is, semen is collected from a healthy from the husband or healthy donor, even husband or as well as a donor, and the semen is introduced into the uterus through vagina by means of a catheter. At the same time, see, the sperm swims towards the fallopian tube and fertilize the egg and results in normal pregnancy. This is intrauterine insemination. Next, we'll see in vitro fertilization, that is IVF or test tube baby. See, in this technique, sperm and eggs are allowed to unite, that is allowed to fertilize outside the body. And then many eggs with the many sperms are fertilized. One or more fertilized eggs may be transferred. One or two eggs are maybe transferred into the woman's uterus where they implant. Suppose see here. Where they implant in the uterine lining, and then they start what? Developing. Suppose excess embryos already, it is fertilized with many eggs, no? One or two are introduced into the uterus. The remaining embryos are preserved by means of a method called cryopreservation. That is in what method? That is frozen method. See, this IVF usually used to treat women with blocked, damaged or absent fallopian tubes. But today IVF is used to treat many causes of what? Infertility. These are the basic steps in IVF. That is ovarian stimulation, egg retrieval, fertilization, embryo culture and embryo transfer. We will see egg retrieval. That is how eggs are collected. Egg retrieval is done by minor surgery or under general anesthesia using ultrasound guide. That before egg retrieval, that first one they will see this injection, human chorionic gonadotropic injection. When the injection is given, after 34 to 37 hours, the eggs are collected. Then at the same time, sperm preparation is also done. See, 10,000 sperms, 10,000 or 1 lakh sperms, 1 lakh sperms. Motile sperms are needed for each egg. Oru egg fertilize pandradhukku 10,000 la irundhu 1 lakh sperms vandhu thevaipadudhu. Adukapram, when it fertilizes, they form what? Zygote. And these zygote are allowed to divide after how many stages? No, 8 cell stage. That 8 cell stage is called as blastomere stage. 8 cell stage is called as what? Blastomere. This blastomere is only introduced into the uterus for successful pregnancy. So the transfer of an embryo with more than eight cell stage in the uterus is called as what technique? No, embryo transfer technique. This is called as what? Embryo transfer technique. Third method, zygote fallopian transfer, that is ZIT. Same like IVF, the zygote up to same eight blastomere stage. It is transferred into the fallopian tube by laparoscopy. Then the zygote continue its natural division, and then automatically it migrate towards the uterus, and in the uterus it gets implanted and start growing. Fourth method, gamete intrafallopian. Gamete intrafallopian transfer. That is gift. In this method, that is, ovum is collected from donor and it is introduced into the fallopian tube. That is, the eggs are collected from the ovaries from the donor and it is placed with the sperms in one of the fallopian tube. That is, sperms also collected and it is placed in the fallopian tube. That is, the ovum as well as sperm placed in the fallopian tube. Where fertilization takes place, then the zygote automatically travels and re-implant in the uterus. The next method is intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Injection ICSI. See, in this method, only one sperm is injected into the, that is, it is injected into the cytoplasm of the ovum. See, only one sperm is injected into the cytoplasm of the ovum, that it should be done very carefully, and fertilization occurs 85% of eggs injected with the sperms. Then it undergoes, after fertilization, it forms what? Zygote, that is diploid zygote. These undergoes division and form 8-cell stage. What is the 8-cell stage called? Blastomere. And then this 8-cell stage blastomere is transferred into the uterus to develop a protective pregnancy. The next one we'll see, Sarrugosi. Sarrugosi means vadagai thai. This is also a method of assisted reproduction or agreement. That is, whereby a woman agrees to carry pregnancy for another person. The person who agrees, those person will be the parent for the newborn child. So, how this Sarrugosi method is done, no? Through first in vitro fertilization. Through in vitro fertilization, what are created? Embryos are created. And these embryos are transferred into surrogate's mother's uterus. Next, we'll see detection of fetal disorder during early pregnancy. Now, let us see detection of fetal disorder during pregnancy. How to detect this fetal disorder? First one is ultrasound scanning. This ultrasound scanning is usually performed in first trimester. That is a determination of to determine number of fetuses, ethana kodan therikun paakarathu, and also for assessment of, suppose if any pregnancy complications, early pregnancy complications can be detected by using ultrasound scanning. Second method is amniocentesis. See, what is amniocentesis? Taking a sample of amniotic fluid where it is formed, it surrounds the fetus. To diagnose any chromosomal abnormalities. So, through amniocentesis method, chromosomal abnormalities can be detected. And how this fluid is taken? By using a thin needle through the abdomen into the amniotic sac, and they withdraw the small sample of amniotic fluid. And this fluid contains that is cells that sheds from the fetus. And the fetus lende the within the cells vandu the amniotic fluid la irukum. Idu eppa usually eppa in the test paapanga appadina 15th and 20th week of pregnancy. 15th and 20th week of pregnancy. Then third one is chorionic villus sampling. Chorionic villus sampling. See, in this method, this is the prenatal test that involves taking a sample of placental tissue. Sample of placental tissue. And this also used to detect same only. In the previous test, we have seen, no, what is the chromosomal abnormalities. Chromosomal abnormalities. Abnormalities. The next one. And the fetoscope. Fetoscope. This fetoscope is used to monitor the fetal heart rate and also other functions during late pregnancy and labor. Usually the average fetal heart rate is 120, that is, and 160 per minute. 120 and 160 per minute. Suppose abnormal fetal heart rate or the pattern may mean that the fetus is not getting enough oxygen. Suppose if there is abnormal heart rate means, then it shows that the fetus is not getting enough oxygen and it indicates other problems also. Then another device is used, that is handheld Doppler. This is also often used during prenatal visit to count the fetal heart rate, and also during labor, continuous electronic fetal monitoring is also often used. That's all about this. Thank you.